Defence sources that a senior US general said to you that the British Army is no longer regarded as a tier one force. How do you respond to that?
Well, look, first of all, I've been very clear for a number of years now as Defence Secretary that the British Army has fallen behind its peer group and needed investment. And that's why Boris Johnson in 2020 gave us a record settlement, supported by Rishi when he was Chancellor, of £16 billion extra in order to invest in our army. And we're starting to do that right now. And as I give you this interview, there are people making armoured vehicles in Telford and tanks and all sorts of things which are the result of that investment.
Now, clearly there are people inside the building and across defence that are very worried about the current hollowing out of the army. Yes, you have a plan for modernisation, but they say it will not deliver fast enough because the threat is now and you need more money faster. What are you going to do about it?
Well, firstly, it's not the currently hollowing out. Defence has been hollowed out under Labour and Conservative for something like 20, 30 years. I was serving in the armed forces when that hollowing was going out. It was that long ago. This is the point that, you know, the music starts to stop, the direction of travel changes. We've had a very predominantly peaceful and stable world for the last 20 years. That is not the case anymore. Russia is, you know, inflicting a war on Europe, in Europe, against Ukraine. The rise of China, the tensions in the Pacific, radicalization across Africa, the world is becoming more unstable and more insecure, and I think that's why, you know, the Prime Minister at the time in 2020 and Rishi recognised there's a requirement to meet that new threat. But it's not a new thing, hollowing out. What we're seeing now is the consequences of hollowing out. And, you know, as a Defence Secretary, I've always said I'm not going to pretend things are perfect. I'm not going to sort of say, look over here, look at the red arrows and troop in the colour. I'm going to actually say, that's what's going on behind the scenes and we're going to try and fix it. And I would rather have a perfectly formed, properly protected men and women of the armed forces of a size we can afford and an ambition we can afford than pretend we're somehow, you know, reaching beyond ourselves.
Okay, now, your armed forces minister just said that the army needs urgent recapitalisation, that the PM gets it and a budget is coming. What does he mean by that?
Well, it does need urgent recapitalisation and that's why we're investing it. We're investing £34 billion in the Army's equipment plan between now and 2033. That's new helicopters, that is new tanks, new armed personnel carriers, new electronic warfare, in a whole range of suite to modernise their fleet, something that didn't happen in my day, and I think it's really, really important that the public understand we are doing it. Now, the criticism about it needs to happen now is these things don't happen now. There's no magic wand, there's no factories whirring away like car factories that you just press buttons and out they come. There are only about two countries on the earth that can sustain almost constant production lines. That's China and the United States. And, you know, of course we can seek to buy from abroad, but then there won't be a UK defence and aerospace industry, and we won't be able to necessarily give our troops the exact equipment they want. So we have to always make that balance. But, you know, Ukraine is exposed. Its supply chains have been frozen or you know, out of commission for far too long. We face that challenge. Spain, Germany, France, Italy, all the European countries face that challenge. And that's what that new money is going towards. And that's why it's important to send a demand signal to industry to say we are investing. That's what we did with the Defence Command Paper in 2020. We'll continue to do so.
Now, finally, what is the danger for UK security if the PM does not give you the increase in funding of £3 billion a year that defence sources say is needed for the army?
Well, look, I'm not going to go into these defence sources. I think, first and foremost, we have a comprehensive spending plan that takes us roughly to the end of 2024. We're on track to continue that investment. I think the reality is, as I've always said, is we need to modernise our armed forces and keep pace. But there's also another thing that we can do in government, which is make sure that we match our appetite with the size of our stomach. You know, we can do lots of things as the British Armed Forces. Our armed forces are some of the best in the world. But of course, what we mustn't do is overreach or overpromise and try and do everything for everybody, because that's in the end how you get in financial problems. So I think it's a two-way discussion. How much do you want to do? That's how much it's going to cost. And then we come to an arrangement. But let's see what happens in the next few weeks and months.
Okay, thank you very much.